So we decided to unleash the handbrake of the TDA1541. As the only company in the world, we offer the TDA1541 with an external frequency generator based on tubes. And these tubes provide the sound, the characteristic of tubes to a digital process. So the accuracy is improved with the help of tubes. I think the results for our design speak for themselves. I don't think there is any other DAC, including my other top favorite on my list, that come close in terms of how organic and natural the sound and how analog basically the sound can be. TDA1540 and 1541 are very closely related DACs, and the TDA1540 came out first. It was a sort of outcome of miscommunication between Philips and Sony. Sony developed the 16-bit polycarbonate CDs, the media, and Philips thought that the more ideal bit depth would be 14-bit, so the TDA1540, the first commercially made R2R DAC, was 14-bit. So what makes the TDA1541 and TDA1540 so special is the integrated mechanism that improves the accuracy called the DEM, dynamic element matching. So dynamic element matching was the original part of all TDA1540 and TDA1541 DAC chips. The 6 bits MSB inside the TDA1540 and 41 are actively activated. The DEM feature is an oscillator that oscillates at a certain frequency, and it helps the 6-bit active bit dividers oscillate at the frequency to average all the quantization errors. And that in turn improves the accuracy of the MSB of the first 6 bits. This idea was great, but it was never really implemented properly by Philips. They just moved on. They never had an external oscillator feeding the DEM. They just installed a capacitor on the input, I think pins 16 and 17, and that's it. And that would ensure the oscillation frequency and keep it stable. This is not an active, it's a passive, low-cost passive solution, and that was part of all the Philips TDA1540, 1541 DACs or CD players back in the days. And it has never changed. They moved on to the noise shaping and the lower cost DACs. That's where the world went into. Cheaper to produce, numbers are good, everybody happy, all good. And the only company that tried to implement the DEM feature with an external active oscillator or clock generator was Grundig. They made an external oscillator, and it was, I think, on one of their CD players, and that was it. Now, where we come in is the execution and implementation of that external oscillator, which would feed into our TDA1541 DAC. I like to say that the best sound was produced by an oscillator that was asynchronous and that used tubes instead of transistors with a tube power supply. That gave us the best sort of results, and this is all part of our DAC 3, DAC 4, DAC 5, DAC X designs. We are the only company that actually commercially offers this solution in the TDA1541, where we have an external DEM generator that produces the superior lifelike liquid organic sound that no other TDA1541 able to produce ever. So we took the technology on the idea, we developed it, we made it work with vacuum tubes instead of transistors. Now we designed the active frequency generator feeding the TDA1541 and 40, and we designed this external frequency generator to work on tubes. So technically a tube-based pacemaker that feeds and regulates the accuracy of all the switching processes within this active MSB 6-bit dividers, that's being controlled with an external pacemaker based on tubes. So this is the closest, gives us the most ideal results when it comes to reproducing digital data and converting into analog musical signal. when choosing a product, one should evaluate everything without a sort of prejudices, preconceptions about something. So if you look at the what we do, and you see that TDA1543 is about performance level 1, and you see that the TDA1541 only starts at level 3, and then we keep the TDA1541 up on DEM DAC X, which are our top performance level. One can ask themselves, why do we keep the TDA1541 in our DAC 3, 4, and 5, and X? So we use this DAC like up there on the top. And why the price is so different between the DAC 3 and the DAC 5? Does this price correspond to improvement in quality of sound? My answer is yes, because the materials and components, the environment, the implementation of TDA1541 is improved and each in a higher performance level, which gives even more of all these desirable analog organic features that we like about the TDA1541. And in the DAC X, we try to get away from silicon as much as possible. We end up virtually everything being tubes. Only the transistors inside the TDA1541 and the chip itself just remains as it is. The best way to experience this, as the saying goes, the proof is in the pudding, is actually to try out and see for oneself how much improvement one gets from, say, from a DAC, if we move from a DAC 3 to DAC 4, DAC 5, and to DAC X. That is a part of our performance level system.